Now, we are going to take up one more problem on projections of laminas. The problem number 123, how to solve this problem by using AutoCAD software. The problem reads as, a hexagonal lamina of side 25 mm rests on one of its sides on VP. The side opposite to the side on which it rests is 30 mm in front of VP, and the side on which it rests makes 45 degrees to HP. Draw its projections, also determine the inclination with the reference planes. So to do that, so first we'll go for the solution here, which is of this is the solution what we need to do. So to do that, first we'll go for the AutoCAD screen, and here you switch off the grid mode and switch on the ortho mode. So the command is limits. So here specify lower left corner by default 0, 0, enter it, upper right corner 297, 210, then zoom all, then go to line, select some arbitrary point on the lower left corner of the screen and click on first button of the mouse and drag the mouse towards the side, right side, and take some distance and click on first button of the mouse. Again, you drag the mouse to the top side, take some distance and click on first button of the mouse, and then go to offset. Take the distance as 297. You select this vertical line and offset to the left side. And again, go to the offset, take the distance as 210. Select this horizontal line and offset to the top side. Then go to zoom extents and zoom 0.6 or 5x. Then go to fillet between this vertical and this horizontal. Similarly, between horizontal and vertical, and between this vertical and this horizontal. Now we are going to try to solve this problem. So since we don't have any locus to be found out, then we are going to create this layer. Click on new, type the layer by name XY, enter. Click on new, type the layer by name front view, enter. Click on new, type the layer by name top view TV, enter. Now first, layer 0 will contain the projector lines. All the projector lines will be of 0.05. So you select the layer 0 is made out of 0.05. Then layer XY will going to have the XY line will be 0.13. And the front view, all the front view lines will be of 0.5. And okay. And all the top view lines will be of also as 0.5. And say okay. Now the color of the top view should be magenta color. You just click on that. And the color of the front view should be having blue color. You just click on that and say okay, and then say close. Now we go for the solution to be drawn. So first we're going to draw the hexagon of 25 mm. So to do that, so just go to polygon, take the number of sides as 6. So take the edge option. So you just click some point and you drag this on this side, take the distance as 25. So once you do that, so you just move this and place it wherever you want, and then go to ortho mode, then go to line, select arbitrary point and drag this, then go to line, take int of this and draw perpendicular to this, then go to line, take int of this and draw perpendicular to this, and then go to line, take int of this and drag perpendicular to this. Now then go to fillet between this line and this, and between this line and this, then go to zoom, you take this, then you select this one and you make this layer as front view, and you select this line as escape this, and then go to layer, select this and make this as top view, then go to break, break this line front view F, take this int and then drag this. So once you do that, so now we have taken this. So lane weight display you switch on, then go to line, you take intersection part of this and drag the horizontal line, you take this. Once you do that, so you copy this here to the next position and then take the distance as 30 mm. So to do that, so first we need to identify what should be the distance. So since I need to calculate the distance, so I need to go for modify. So click on the primary units, take up to second decimal point, then go to text. So take the text height as 3 and then go to align with the dimension line, So vertical will going to become above, text placement is above, then the offset from the dimension line as 3, then go to symbols and arrow size, take the arrow size as 3 and say lines. So go to offset from the origin as 3 and say OK and say close. Now he says the distance from here to here it is 30. So to do that, so first we'll go to the offset, take the distance as 30 mm. And you take this line and offset by 30 mm. Now first we'll go for dimension, then go to intersection point of this, and then take INT of this. So you go 43.30. Then go to copy. So here, then go to copy, select this line, and also you select this line, and copy this to the next position at some distance. Then you, sorry, then just undo it, then go to circle, take nearest point on this, any point on this, take the radius as 43.30. Once you do that, then go to break, select this line or a circle and break this here, and you break it on this side, then go to erase, erase this line and also erase this line, and then go to copy, you select this, and you select this, go to intersection point of this. And what is the center point of this? The center point of this is center of this arc. So once you take the center here, it will copy to that location. Then go to rotate, select objects, you select these two, then enter base point. We will going to take end point of this. Then we need to take the reference. You take the reference, specify the reference angle, again the reference angle, that is the original angle, what is the position of this to be rotated object. The position of the rotated object with reference to this point is 0 degree, so by default it is already 0. You just press enter, and then the new angle, I need to specify this as intersection point of this, so you will going to get that point here. So now we can see that it has been rotated by this angle. Then go to line, take INT of this. So we are going to draw this line. So he has asked to find out the new angle. So now we will go to dim and take angular, select between this line and this line. So as we see the text, so here we, if you type text, so the text angle is 44 degree. So here what we have is 43.85. So now we need to adjust the position of the precision as 0 degree. So here the main problem was, so the main problem is we need to change the angular dimension here to second decimal point. So to do that, once you do this, then we go for dim, select angular, you select this between these two. So now we are going to get it as 43.86. That dimension is again theta is equal to 43.85. So up to the second decimal point, we are getting this as 43.86. That is because of the second decimal point round off. So once you do that, you will going to get it as 43.86. So you will go to text, and then you make it as 0. So here it will going to appear as this. Now we need to write the front view. So go to line, take INT of this and draw a horizontal line. Again, you take line INT of this and draw a horizontal line, and take INT of this and draw it perpendicular to this. So similarly, line, you take INT of this and draw perpendicular to this, then go to trim, select this cutting edge as this as the cutting edge and object to trim as this, then go to line, take INT of this and draw a horizontal line. Similarly, INT of this and draw a horizontal line, and go to line, take endpoint of this and draw perpendicular to this line. So then go to trim, select this as the cutting edge and object to trim as this. Then go to line, take INT of this and take intersection point of this and take intersection point of this. Then go to line, take INT of this and take intersection point of this and take INT of this. Then go to break, break this line first point, you take INT of this and say at the rate, then you take break first point, INT of this and say at the rate, then break first point, take int of this and say @. Similarly, you break first point, take int of this and say @, then break first point, take int, sorry, break first, select this as a, then break first point, take int of this and say @, then break first point, take int of this and say @. Now we have breaked all these points. So here you just, this is not broken correctly, then go to extend this line till here. So this is also one of the method where you can do it. But once you do that, now we need to change this to the front view. You just click on this, sorry, undo it, then go to select all these 5-6 lines and go to layer, change that layer to front view. Once you do that, now we need to copy this to the next position. So to do that, and then rotate by an angle of 45 degree in counterclockwise direction, then go to copy, select this entire thing by window and copy to the next position, and then go to rotate this by an angle of 45 degrees. Once you do that, so now we need to write the top view now. So to do that, so go to line, take int of this and draw perpendicular to this, and then go to line, take int of this and draw perpendicular to this line. Similarly, line, take int of this and draw perpendicular to this, then go to line, take int of this and draw perpendicular to this, then go to line, draw a horizontal line now here, then go to line, take int of this and draw perpendicular to this. Similarly, line, take int of this and draw perpendicular to this. Now then go to fillet between these two lines. So similarly, then go to line, take int of this and take intersection point of this and take int of this, then go to line, take int of this and take intersection point of this and take int of this, then go to fillet between this and this. Now we go for a break command. Break first point, take int of this and say @, then break first point, take int of this and say @, then break first point, take int of this and say @, then go to break this line till here. Now you just go to line command and draw a line from this side also to some distance. So you just click on this, you just click on this and you click on this, go to layer, you make that layer as XY and then escape. Now you just select this line, this and this. So you just make the layer as front view, top view. So you just trim this, go to trim, select this at the cutting edge and object to trim as this. Now we go for detext or dimensioning. So go to DDIM, select modify. So just primary units, you make it precision as 0 and decimal precision as 0. Say OK and say close. Now you just go to erase this, which is not required. So dim, go to nearest point on this and take perpendicular to this. So you're going to get 30 mm. Then go to angular, select between this line and this line. So you're going to get 45 degrees. And then dim, you take intersection point of this and take int of this. So you're going to get it as 25 mm here. Now we go for detext. So you select some arbitrary point and take the height as 3 and then rotation angle as 0. So make this as capital X VP and this as HP and this as Y. So now you just switch off the caps lock and write A dash and similarly B dash, similarly C dash, then you make mark it as D dash and then you mark it as E dash and this as F dash. So here you mark it as A, B and C, and similarly you mark it as D and you mark it as E and you mark it as F now. So once you do that, So then you just go to move, switch off the ortho mode, and you take X and this as VP and this as HP. So you mark this as A dash, this as B dash, and this as C dash. Of course, D dash is already there. Then mark it as E dash, then F dash, then go to A, then B, then C, then D, then E, then F. One should do that. So you mark all this and change this to VP, that is the layer as front view, and then escape. So you take this and you take this layer as top view. Once you do that, then go to copy. So you mark this as A and you mark this as B, you mark this as C, you mark this as D, you mark this as E, you mark this as F, you mark this as A dash, you mark this as B dash, you mark this as C dash, you mark this as D dash, and then E dash, and then F dash. Once you do that, so again you copy this here, A dash, then B dash, then C dash, then D dash, then E dash, then F dash. So one should do that. So now you take this as D, you take it as A, you mark it as B, you mark it as C, and D, and E, and F. Then go to move. So you take A, and you take B, you take C, you take D, you take E, you take F. So one should do that. You just go to A, B, C, D, E, and F. Make this layer as top view. So this is how. Then you just go to dim, TED, text edit dimension for this arrow. You select this and take it inside. Then go to M text. So you select this and you make it formatting. Go to symbol. So you take symbol and you type it as small F5. Now we need to write the answer for this. So to write the answer, so just come down to zoom window, then go to D text. So here type 43.85. So in our case, what we got is 43.86. So just you write 43.86 percentage D. So then you just go to line, put on the ortho mode, and you drag this and you write this here. So then go to fillet between these two, then you just copy this here. So put on the ortho mode, then go to zoom window, then go to offset, take the distance as 6. So then go to line, take nearest point on this and take perpendicular to this. So then move. So you take it wherever you want and place it, and go to fillet between this and this, similarly between these two, and this is erase. Then move, switch on the ortho mode, and you take this and place it wherever you want. Then go to fillet between this and this, and between this and this. So this is how you're going to get it in a presentable format. Then go to previous, zoom previous, then go to D text. So this will going to be the answer. So this is how you will be able to create the drawing by using AutoCAD software. So this drawing and this drawing is more or less similar. Thank you.